वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरान्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनीति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणीप्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सर्वशास्त्राब्धि पीयूष सर्ववेदैक सत्फल सर्वसिद्धांत रत्नाढ्य सर्वलोकैक दृक्पद सर्वभागवतो प्राणो श्रीमद्भागवतो प्रभु कलिध्वन्तादितादित्त श्रीकृष्ण परिवर्तित परमानन्द पाठाय पमवश्यक्षराय ते सर्वदा सर्वसेवाय श्रीकृष्णाय नमस्तुते मदक बंधु मत्संगीन मद्गुरु मन्महादन मान्निष्ठारक मद्भाग्य मदानंद नमस्तुते असाधु सदुतादायी नुति निच्छुता करो हाणमुंच कदाचिन्म प्रेम्णा हृत्कंठिस्फुरः कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय हरये परमात्मने परणत क्लेशनाशाय गोविंदाय नमो नमः रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 1 चैप्टर एंटाइटल्ड द एडवेंट ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा इंट्रोडक्शन टेक्स्ट नंबर 54 श्री वसुदेव उवाच नहि अस्यस्ते भयं सौम्य यद्वै साहसि शरीरवाक् पुत्रान् समर्पयिष्यस्य यतस्ते भयमुत्थितम् वट् मीनिंग श्री वसुदेव उवाच श्री वसुदेव सेट ना नॉट ही इंडीड अस्यः फ्रॉम देवकी ते ऑफ यू भयम् फियर सौम्य ओ मोस्ट सोबर यत विच वै इंडीड सा दैट वुमन आहा dictated ashrira vak a vibration without a body putran all my sons samarpayishe I shall deliver to you asyaha of her yatah from whom te your bhayam fear उत्थितम हैज अराइजन ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपोर्ट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवंद स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जाए वसुदेव सेड ओ बेस्ट ऑफ द सोबर यू हैव नथिंग टू फियर फ्रॉम योर सिस्टर देवकी बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट यू हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम द अनसीन वुमन द कॉज ऑफ डेथ विल बी हर सन्स देयरफोर I promise that when she gives birth to the sons from whom your fear has arisen, I shall deliver them all unto your hands. Purport comes of feared Devaki's existence because after her 8th pregnancy, she would give birth to a son who would kill him. Vasudeva therefore, to assure his brother-in-law the utmost safety, promised to bring him all the sons. He would not wait for the eighth son, but from the very beginning would deliver to the hands of Kamsa all the sons to which Devaki would give birth. This was the most liberal position offered by Vasudeva to Kamsa. So there is a series of verses, and this is the last verse. So in this verse, Vasudeva come to conclusion that how can he settle the situation now? Previously, he tried many ways to pacify Kamsa. Someone other, Kamsa was not pacified. Then Vasudeva was thinking what to do. Anyway, I have to save my wife, because it is a duty of a husband to save the wife, because when both husband and wife get married, husband take vows in front of Agni, fire, that until her death I will give her safety. Correct. So it is a duty of Vasudeva. This is the one reason. Second reason is said that, I think, what is his name? 50 or 48 verse also said that one should try to protect oneself with intelligence and bala, means buddhi and bala, as much as possible to protect himself. So in the sense also we see, if Vasudeva don't try to protect Devaki, then it becomes sin, because not using his intelligence and strength. So question might come, why one have to try to protect oneself from others? That is the speciality of human. Only human can do this, because they have a higher intelligence, they have a mind also, everything. So that's why we see in the human society, to protect oneself, we try many ways. There is a hospital everywhere, and there is many ways trying to protect oneself. Anyway, so it is the dharma of Vasudeva to protect. Then Vasudeva come to conclusion, okay, see, the problem is that whatever sons come from Devaki, and that also eight son is going to kill Kamsa, not all the sons, only eight sons going to kill the Kamsa. So problem is that if I give eight sons to last, that's it, actually Astama Garve, it's not mentioned the son or daughter, it's not mentioned, only eight one, Astama Garva means like this, 8-1 is going to kill. That also, Devaki Garva means in the womb of, who will take birth in the womb of Devaki, he or she is going to kill. So now question again came, okay, anyway, this Devaki might get child either from me or from someone else. But Vasudeva was thinking that it cannot be mine also. It can mine also, correct? Because Devaki's from Devaki's womb only that someone is going to kill Kamsa. So fear is not me. Kamsa doesn't have any fear on me. Kamsa has a fear on Devaki. So then Vasudeva was thinking, if I don't get any child, what will happen? Vasudeva was thinking, suppose the cause of fear is 8-1. If we don't get any child, no problem. But again, seeing that, that's not possible. Because eight son is going to come, and that is the Supreme Lord, because he knew already. So Vasudeva also trying to bring eight sons. So now, if I because he is so much ecstatic to have Lord as his son. So, but he wants to bring Lord, but I want son. But now again, problem is that suppose if I give all the sons to Kamsa, but there is again offense. What is the offense? You said that because eighth son is going to be supreme lord, and what I am doing, I am going to give up the supreme lord. Correct? I am going to give up the supreme lord because I supposed to keep supreme lord, but instead of keeping, I am giving up. And how is it possible? Is it not offense? Giving up supreme lord is offense from Vasudev's side. And I cannot do that also. So that's why in this verse there is some technical point up there. Very technical. If you try to analyze, see, last line if you see, yataste bhayam uttitam. Yataste, that means that actually there is a Sanskrit rule. Say this, o eo bhayam hare avayam hare avishnu padante. That means after E or O, if there is a A, this A get deleted. Then we don't pronounce that A at all. We pronounce last one. Instead of Bhayam, it becomes Abhayam. But when you delete it, we pronounce it with previous word. Then what will happen? Te Bhayam. Instead of Te Abhayam. Then what's happening? That means, who is the cause of the fear? I am not going to give that to Kamsa. I'll give all the sons. All the sons I'll give. That means, I'll give till 7 sons, not the 8 one. Because I cannot give up that. So, previously also he said that Kamsa was, some other he said, let me protect my wife. And he also started thinking, anyway, my son is going to kill. And anyone is going to kill. It's not that only 8 ones. So previously also in the one class I explained, the 8 could be counted from any side. Correct? That I said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And if you count from the lies, first one is 8. If you come from the middle, it could be anyone. So then Kamsa started, so Vasudeva started thinking, how will it be possible that my son is going to kill Kamsa? Then here he said that maybe destiny has some arrangement. Because providence said that someone other, this 8th son will kill. So that's why Vasudeva started thinking, maybe destiny will protect. So example we see, sometime we try to do something, but happens something else. Is it that because of it happened because of previous action? So example is given like, see, Bharat Maharaj went to forest. For what purpose? To perform austerity, correct? To perform austerity. His purpose was something else, but what happened to him at the end? He became attached with the deer and he forgot the Supreme Lord and he started maintaining the deer, and next time he took birth as a deer. So Vasudeva was thinking these things, that see, we don't know what is destiny. I don't know. So let me someone other save my wife now. Now how to save? That's why he came to conclusion that my cause of fear is my son, not my wife. If I deliver my son, all the sons to Devaki, except 8th one, and the cause of fear over, there will not be any cause of fear. Then Vasudeva also started thinking, how it will be possible that my son will kill Kamsa? He's thinking that anyway, maybe one of my son will be very strong and he'll kill Kamsa. But again he started thinking, how is it possible? Kamsa is a great warrior. How is it possible? How he'll kill? Then Vasudha started thinking anyway. But Vasudha didn't know that Kamsa will arrest him. He don't know that. But anyway, if till the seventh child killed, if I can get some strength, I can get some soldier, and I can protect myself. Or he's thinking that, let me settle the situation right now, whatever we have right now, because someone other I have to protect. If I can pacify now someone other Kamsa by giving my all my son to Kamsa, then because of the love and affection towards the Devaki, Kamsa might forget also. He might forget. So if Kamsa forget, then what will happen? Everything is over. And also he said that if I give all my son to Kamsa, if I don't keep any son with me, if I give to Kamsa, it will belongs to Kamsa, and it will be son of Kamsa. Then what will happen? Kamsa will not kill his own son, and as a father, as a son, son also will not kill the father. So that also problem solved. So many argument he started thinking with this one concept that I have to give protection to Devaki. We see sometime, that's why Vasudha was so much, you know, in line, or he was believing so much this destiny. He was thinking that some or other one son will survive and he will kill Vasudeva. That we see example in our day-to-day life, examples also. Like, I remember, I think there was a cyclone, 87 or something like that. 87, something. There was a big cyclone. I don't remember the exact year. You know, the cyclone was completely different. That so many people died. There was a big flood. In the flood, and water came, you know, water level raised so much. And there are many people, old people died. But I saw one small child, 5 years old, doesn't know how to swim. And he was floating, suddenly he got on one tree. And he just hold the tree, caught the tree. And he was there in the same tree for 2 days, but he didn't die. He didn't die. I was shocked. How is it possible that there are many people, those are the best swimmer, they died, but this person didn't die. That's called destiny. So if Krishna wants to save someone, who can kill? If Krishna wants to kill someone, who can save? And another example I have seen, we had one big mango tree. Big mango tree. And also we had some other small tree also. In the same cyclone, I saw that this big mango tree was uprooted from the place and thrown somewhere else. But that near the big tree, there was a small tree. Nothing happened to the tree. It's a shock. How is it possible? So that's why it's called destiny. If Lord has some plan for each and everything. So here also, Vasudha was thinking, some or other, save my wife, because Krishna is going to come, Lord is going to come. Because he heard previously that Lord is going to be a child. So that's why previously in 53 verse, Vasudha started laughing. How he was laughing? Like a friendly, he was laughing to pacify Kamsa. You're thinking that, oh, anyway, the cause of fear is my son. Correct? Okay. You don't worry. Don't worry. I'll give my son to you. Then all the problems solve. But Basudeva is saying, I'll give. But what happened to inside? Do you think that inside he is jubilant? Inside, he has a fear. What kind of fear? Kamsa will accept or not my proposal. He has a fear. Prabhupada said. The Vishwanatha Kutataka said on this. He said it. Inside he had so much fear. But outside he was showing. What he is showing? That Kamsa, I think, like a friendly mood. Yeah, don't worry, I'll take care. And also he was speaking in such a way that Vasudeva is trying to help Kamsa to come out from the fear. Actually, we are both our friend, because Vasudeva and Kamsa, both are good friend. He said that your fear means my fear. There is no difference. So it is my duty as a friend to free you from the fear. So how to do it? Anyway, whatever sons come from Vasudeva, Devaki, I'll give you all. Except that yasmat bhayam. Nah. I'll give you, but not that from whom you have a fear. So that's why it's very interesting that when Vasudeva got pacified, he was so happy and he believed Vasudeva's word. He believed Vasudeva's word because Kamsa knows the nature of Vasudeva. He's so truthful. He doesn't lie. He's so truthful. So now the question might come, how is it possible? Being demon, Kamsa believing Vasudeva's word. How is it possible? It is said that it's possible. Because we see our external world. In our day-to-day life, we see. Normally, sometimes it happens that those are atheists. They know scripture better than us. Sometimes it appeared. How? If you stay and if you don't follow any rules, regulation of the scriptures, if non-devotees see, immediately they try to find fault. Come on, you're supposed to follow this. You're supposed to follow this. Correct? They say this. How do they say? So, although they don't have faith on the scriptures, but they know. They know. They don't have faith. And they try to find fault on us. See, you're supposed to do like this. You're supposed to do like this. But you are not doing it. So, you should do it. It happened. Same thing is happening in the case of this Kamsa. He doesn't have at all faith in his scriptures. But he knows. So that's why here the plan is some or other to protect Devaki. And Vasudeva also started thinking another point. He said that suppose if I give my son to Kamsa, okay, if death come also, maybe death might go away from my son. Because in the scripture, there are many examples that that personification come and that goes also. Anybody remember example? Like Azamila. Yamadutu came and left without taking Azamila. So Vasudeva started remembering that maybe what will happen if death come? By seeing my son, that will go away. So my son will not die and he will kill Kamsa. This is one point. Another point, he is thinking, maybe, although this Kamsa is trying to save himself, but he started remembering Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu also tried many ways to protect himself from the death, but ultimately he was killed by Narasimhadev. So Vasudeva was thinking that anyway, Kamsa, he is going to be killed by my son, and that will happen because providence said. So I have a full faith. Now some or other, protect my wife. It's called Stri Dharma. Pati Dharma, correct? Pati Dharma. I have to protect. If I can protect, then I will not commit sin. If I don't protect her, I will commit sin. Okay. So then question can come. So now he's trying to protect. Then again he's thinking that, okay, anyway, this is first time I am trying to protect my wife. If again Kamsa attack, what will happen? If again Kamsa try to kill, what I should do? Shall I try to protect or not? So it said that one has to try to protect oneself or belongings as much as possible. So that's why Krishna said, you do your duty. But Krishna never said, don't do anything. I'll do everything. Krishna never said. What is the verse from Bhagavad Gita? Tasmat sarveshu kalesu ma manusmara yuddhasa mayarpita mana buddhi ma evashyasi asamshayaha. No doubt. What is no doubt? That you will achieve me. But there is some condition. What is the condition? You do duty. What is the duty? To fight. You do this and you do it while remembering me. If you do that, you'll get me. No doubt. Similarly, Vasudeva is thinking, so I also have to do my duty. What is the duty? To protect as much, whatever is possible for me, I'll protect. If I protect, then all the problems solve. And also, Vasudeva is very, very, he's very intelligent. In this verse, he used one word, Samyo. Samyo means, Jiva Goswami said, Pashanto. Pashanto means very peaceful. He said, you are very peaceful. Pashanta. But Kamsa is peaceful. It's complete opposite. He's in fear now. He's fear now. And Vasudeva is saying that, you are a Prashanta. You don't have any fear. Keep. And also he said that, Sa aha ashariravak. You have a fear on what? Ashariravak. That person, one person spoke that, but you didn't see him. Without that, you just heard a voice that someone is speaking, and unfortunately, you believed that voice and started creating chaos, destroying Devaki here. So Vasudev was some other. He's reminding, hey, is Ashariravak, someone say like this, you know, why you have to believe that? Anyway, I'm your friend, let us save. I'll save you, don't worry. By giving the son. So again, they're saying that, again, he's saying that, okay, if me and Devaki stay separately, what will happen? Is there any son? No son. No son means no killing. So all the problems solved. So like this way, there are many arguments. Vasudeva thinking and he chose this last option. And this is called, in this verse also, this previously he was using the three ways to convince Kamsa. And in this verse also we see one, this sama means specification, glorification, we see. And also, in this verse it said that bhayam uttitam. Uttitam means that fear arisen. And in some of the versions it is agatam, means fear that came. What is the cause of fear? My putra. This putran, this all my sons are the fear of your death. So you don't worry, I'll settle. So Vasudev took the responsibility to save Kamsa from this situation now. And Kamsa fully believed. Now question might come, Vasudev being a truthful person, can he cheat Kamsa? Is it possible? Take it a materialistic way. Is it good to cheat materialistic people? Like see, someone is someone is trying to cheat you. To protect oneself, can someone take this way of cheating? One of the acharyas said that actually we have to deal the way or the deal. Like someone is trying to cheat you. If that person is materialistic, dehatma buddhi, if he is dehatma buddhi, in dehatma buddhi, and he said that you can cheat that person, there is no wrong. There is no wrong in cheating. Why? Because he doesn't know what is dharma, what is adharma. And whatever you're doing now is trying to protect yourself and your belongings. And it is your dharma. For you, it is dharma, and for him, there is no dharma. Because he doesn't follow anything. So why one has to worry about it? Why? No, not necessary. And also, actually, he remembered one more thing. Vasudeva. He said that, see, the cause of fear, my son. But if son doesn't take birth, no problem. And he was remembering one from Bhishma Dev also. He said that, see, when the Santunu approached Matsyagandha, but there was a prediction that Matsyagandha's son will be the king. But Matsyagandha started thinking that there is already Bhishma Dev. He will be the king. Because he is the eldest son. According to the system, correct? That is system. But now, and Matsyagandha, because of this, not marrying Santanu. Then Bhishma Dev heard it. Oh, that is the fear. Huh? But Bhishma Dev, he is so much concerned about his father. Some other, father. Then what she, Bhishma Dev, he personally went to Matsyagandha. He said, what is the problem? He said, yes, my son will be the king according to prediction, but you are already there. How can my son will be the king? Because it is not the system. And see this, okay. Vishnu was saying, okay, I will not be king. He said, okay, you will not be king. But what about your son? I can believe you, but I cannot believe your son. And then Vishnu was saying, okay, if I don't get married, then what will happen? No son. Then all the problems solve. Correct. Similarly, Vasudeva also thinking many ways because he is very intelligent. Intelligence means what? If one option doesn't work, take another option. If that doesn't work, another option. But still, they don't give up. That is the sign of intelligent person. They don't give up. They will try to solve the problem, this imminent problem, some or other. So Vasudeva also started remembering many things, some or other. I have to protect my wife. So this way, Vasudeva start. This is like a deal, correct? This is like a deal that take and give. I will give my son to you, and you give Devaki to me. That's all. So by this, I can protect, I can save, and Krishna will appear, and Krishna will kill Vasudeva. And after this, what happened? You know, Vasudeva comes to become so happy by the word of Vasudeva, so happy. And what he was doing before? He was driving chariot, correct? Again, he took the rope and started driving. See, this is the Kamsa. That means what? He had so much faith on Vasudeva. And he's so happy with the word of Vasudeva that, yes, he's my real friend. Anyway, let forgive Devaki. Let take her son. And I will be safe. And my dynasty will be safe. Because, see, we also see that Kamsa didn't have any dynasty, correct? No son. Kamsa had son? Something like that? But it's not mentioned anyway. I don't remember. Something like that, he said. Oh, anyway, okay. So, but here, Vasudeva was thinking that I'll give all my son to Kamsa. And normally, if Kamsa is a father, definitely he has some fatherly affection, and he will not be able to kill. Because the son will be belongs to the Kamsa only. So, Vasudeva, the point is that Vasudeva is trying many ways. Let's save Devaki some or other from this imminent death. That's why this is the whole arrangement of Vasudeva, that some or other let us save Vasudeva. So Devaki. By this, what will happen? If I can do this and I will be safe from the sin, what is the sin? That pati dharma. And also that I will not be blamed for that. As a pati, as a husband, you're supposed to save, but you cannot do that. So I will not be blamed. Even Kamsa also will be glorified. Why? Because see, by simply hearing his friend's word, Kamsa convinced, and he didn't kill. Kamsa would be safe from committing sinful activities. Okay, so this way, Vasudeva, he had two minds. One is to save Devaki, another mind is to save Kamsa from committing sin. So many ways, because anyway, if friend is enemy also, those who are devotee, they have some compassion to save friend also. Although he is demon, but he still some compassion. So Vasudeva also started thinking, anyway, let me save my friends also. So it's like with one arrow, killing many birds. So Vasudeva took that way, that some other save. So by this process, Vasudeva saved Kamsa, and Vasudeva saved devaki also from committing that sin. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Yes, Prabhu, any comments? Sankarshan Prabhu, any comments? One more thing is, you know, he said that, you know, as a father, how can he give his son to the Kamsa, who is also sin, correct? Who is also sin? Then one of the acharya said that there are two things that are there. One is called worldly religion, and this is called spiritual. In worldly, it is a duty to save his wife. Spiritually, it's different. Because the affection for Krishna was so much that, you know, that Vasudeva forgot everything. Let me save. Let me keep Krishna with me. So that love became so prominent that, and worldly love became so insignificant. So insignificant. So that's why he said that anyway, this seventh child, you know, let them kill. If I get Krishna, that's enough. My soul is also proved like this. Yes. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna, Gandhara, Shrimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki, Jai.